When I was working as a house surgeon, I felt kind of like I was mowing the lawns, doing the same thing every day. And I wanted to be designing the garden and really understanding how disease worked and maybe trying to find better ways to attack disease and to put disease in its place. I guess one of the biggest examples for me was cancer. It's very rare that a tumour is driven by a single mutation, sometimes hundreds. There's a massive complexity in how all of the cells link together to make a cell be a normal cell. What I wanted to do was understand how the cells worked inside, the complicated molecular pathways which may identify vulnerabilities in an individual cancer or Achilles heels that we can attack through knowledge using different drugs. So we need to understand, using pathway analysis, what's going on at every point. How are these mutations that cancer cells have altering their function? How are the mutations allowing them to resist drugs? And of course, tumours are evolving and changing all the time. So our understanding of these pathways needs to be dynamic. QIAGEN's got several types of software we use. There's QCI Insight, looking at mutations in tumours. There's Ingenuity Pathway Analysis, or IPA, which we also use, looking at gene expression mainly. With all of the thousands of complex molecules inside the cancer cells, we can understand where the regulation of those molecules has gone wrong to allow a cancer to grow out of control. By understanding the pathways, we're just on the cusp of really understanding how individual tumour cells, for example, differ. But it's rather like when you're out on a walk in the bush and you think you've seen the top of the hill, and you get there and then there's an even bigger hill above it. The more we understand about these pathways, the more we realise that we don't understand anything at all. We've still got so far yet to go.
QIAGEN.
Sample to insight.